Oh, he hates the word. Don't you think he in love with the word of God?
Amen.
But it knocked him out the box. Now, you done heard the scripture before said the just shall live by faith.
That's what it says.
But I'm going to bring you one that says the just shall live by his faith. You got to have faith.
Come on
and get it from me here. Church, amen.
God, the devil don't want you to get it.
No, he don't want me.
He fight hard.
He's dirty. But we going to get it. It's something in that thing.
Yes, sir.
I want you to know this, while he's looking for Apostle Paul was somewhere preaching. Amen.
Amen.
While he was preaching, he saw that the person had faith to be healed.
Yes.
And God healed the person.
Amen.
He perceived it. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah to God.
Amen.
Now let me take my time and work with this.
Come on, preacher.
Yeah, just give me Acts 14. Hold that and get Acts 14. I think I'm found it now. Finally.
Amen.
Acts 14.
Amen. 14.
Amen. And we can get it again.
14.
I got it. And they start at the 8th verse.
And thou said, a certain man,
listen good, saints. If you want the victory, you got to have faith. What it said?
And thou said, a certain man,
I'm telling you right now, God is not limited in power. God got power to do everything we need him to do.
He ain't limited in power at all.
Come on, preacher.
But there was a certain place Jesus went, he couldn't do many miracles.
Come on, preacher.
Because of their unbelief.
Come on, preacher.
I'm convinced right now unbelief stopping somebody.
Come on, preacher.
You got to have faith in God. And it's more than talking. It got to be in your heart.
Come on, preacher.
Amen.
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 All right, what it say?
And there sat a certain man at Lystra.
He wasn't talking. He wasn't saying, I believe God. He was just sitting there listening at the word of God.
Praise God. Bishop Gordon said he went somewhere to pray for somebody. And said that they were talking faith. They were talking, I know God is able. I know this. He can do it. He can do this. And he said, shut up. Be quiet. Because he felt there wasn't no faith. There was just mouth talk.
Amen.
You know God's real faith. Bishop said if she'd have had faith, she'd have been out of that bed. Long time ago. That's what he preached. That she'd have died up.
Y'all didn't.
Amen.
Amen. And Bishop Maynard, be quiet,
because that was some old spirit talking. But what the Bible said, they draw nigh to me with their mouth, honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. Your mouth can say anything.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. But the real thing, she was just talking.
Yeah. But after Bishop made her be quiet,
he began to go through the scripture and show her all the things Jesus had done through faith. And she said, I believe. It was real that time. And Bishop said he felt. You know, I want you to know, when a man of God prays for you, he can feel and he know if you got faith.
Glory to God. Church, amen. It's evident in the scriptures what it says here.
And there are a certain man.
There's not a certain man.
At Lystra.
It didn't matter who this man was. Anybody can get victory if they got faith in God.
Mm-hmm. Impotent in his feet. Being a cripple. From his mother.
Look like ain't no hope from him. Born crippled. You know?
Who never had walk.
Never had walk.
The same heard Paul speak.
The same heard Paul speak.
Who steadfastly beholding him,
steadfastly beholding him,
and perceiving that he had faith to be healed.
He had faith for he what?
Perceiving that he had faith.
Paul tracked the man's faith. Paul could see his faith.
Lord, y'all understand that? People play around, say, I'm asking God for this, and I'm asking God for this, and now they tell you to pray, but then you can feel a drawback in there. You can feel an unbelieving spirit fighting against you in there.
Hallelujah, God. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Apostle Paul perceived, he felt, and he saw his faith.
Amen.
Amen. Faith is something you can, my God, the man of God know. You can call him, say, pray for him. But when he go to praying, that thing connects very well
when faith is involved.
Amen. Paul perceived that he had faith to be.
He had to have faith to be healed.
Yes.
Faith to be healed.
What did he say here?
Say it with a loud voice.
Say it with a loud voice.
Stand upright on thy feet.
Get up.
Praise God.
Stand upright on thy feet. Yes. And he leaped and walked.
The man that was crippled from you was born crippled.
Faith
got the man leaping and walking.
Church, amen. Amen. But he wasn't talking. He wasn't saying nothing. But he had faith within himself.
That's right.
You know, you don't have to talk it all the time. But while you're going through, you believe in God and bring it out. Church, amen. Some people talk it, but they don't have it inside. It's a blessing when you got it on the inside of you. That thing will work, and it'll give you some results. Give me a hallelujah. Church, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Yeah, this is a message. You've got to get to the people. You've got to believe God. Read on here.
Two and four.
Yes.
Behold. His soul. Which is lifted up. Is not upright in him.
Not up. Right in him.
But the just shall live by his faith.
By everybody else's faith.
By his faith.
The life you live is determined by your faith.
You got to have
faith. By his faith.
Church, amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, I believe God can give me a house. And somebody else said, I don't believe that, but then you ain't gonna get one.
But the one that believes God ain't gonna give him that house will get that house.
Praise the Lord. Somebody said, I believe God able to bless me. And you sitting there, don't be trying to get, Lord, I got faith, but he ain't gonna give it to me. Leave me alone, let me have faith in my God.
You live by your faith, and I live by my faith.
Amen. God, I believe it. Yeah. Somebody said, when Mother Green was about to get married, she got what she couldn't walk and said she rebuked that devil. Said, the devil, you're lying. Somebody would have said, well, I'm just crippled. That's all. I can't walk.
God, sometimes you don't accept everything the devil gives you.
Don't accept everything the devil put on you. The devil tell you, you, I got control of you. Ain't no way in the world I'm going to let the devil have control of me. I got enough faith to shake that devil off. I got enough to tell, get thee behind me. They'll tell you, you can be heaven all your life. Get behind yourself. Praise the Lord. You got to have faith. God, oh doubtful spirit, Dr. God. I feel it. Keep on God. Praise God. Church, amen. People with no faith, weary. They got all weary spirit.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Believe God. Rebuke that devil. Say amen. Stop this foolish unbelief. Unbelief gives you excuses. Why this and why that? And why this and why that? But faith in God says,
somebody said they believe God. Don't, that's why you shouldn't get jealous of nobody else. People contending to God for what they want. Somebody said, I just can't get nothing. I just can't hang nothing. They ain't excuses. They make excuses about where they at, but they can't get a blessing. So I can't get a blessing here.
I can't get a mind, God. The Bible said everywhere is totally defeat and treasure. God give you grace.
Yes.
If you kick me out of Jacksonville, I'll get blessed in Mexico. Yes. No matter where you put me, I'll get a blessing. If they put me in time for a blessing,
yes.
Put me in Colombia, blessing Colombia.
Yes.
Come on, man.
Hallelujah. Everywhere.
Talking to you, push your phone up and get back. Then it
unbelief in God, he's sick. And Hezekiah was sick unto death.
Yes, he was.
Hallelujah.
He wasn't just what go every day cold. No. This man was dying. Oh. And here come the true prophet.
Yeah.
God said, the Lord set your house in order. You're going to die and not live.
But when you believe God, I know what the prophet said.
Yeah.
But you know what? I'm going to talk to him for myself.
About
all this roundabout talking to him. You ever see people, they keep telling other people to tell you things. Why don't they call you themselves?
I just gave him a message for what I said. I'm going to talk to him my own self.
Church ain't better.
And he turned his face to the Lord and he wept sore. If you want something from God, you got to seek him until you get an answer from him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. There is a point you can seek God. If it's not his will, he will give you an answer.
Yes, he will.
That's the truth.
Yes,
He told Lazarus, something said, said I not unto thee, if thou wouldest believe, thou shalt see the glory of God. Some way or another, God got to show you his glory because you believe in him.
Yeah.
Bishop Treat said in what he was praying, something that wasn't God's will. So he was praying that God raise somebody from the dead, but it was God's will for them to be gone. So God killed somebody else and raised them from the dead to compensate his faith. What I'm trying to tell you, if you seeking God for something, see, that's what the devil gets people. They'll say, it must not be God's will, and they just let it go. But you hold God until the point, if it's not his will, he got to compensate you with something else. Hold him anyhow.
You get it.
Hold God until he got to do something.
You understand.
Glory to God, you understand.
Amen. All right, what it said here? Read that thing. Go, give me Hebrew 10. I thank God for the word. Amen. Seek the Lord and live. All right. Amen. We're walking through slow tonight, but it's all right anyhow.
Amen.
Amen.
Hebrew 10 and start at the 35th verse.
You got to hold your confidence in God.
Amen.
While you believe in God, while you praying, the devil can tell you all kinds of things.
That's right.
The people themselves will tell you things that are not your faith if you don't believe. You ain't strong in faith. Amen. Amen. But no matter what nobody says, you believe God anyhow. All right, what it said?
Mm-hmm.
10:35. What? Cast not away. Cast not away.
Therefore, your confidence.
Say something, be honest. If confidence go a long way and you're in trouble and you believe in God and praise God. When you just confident in your God, the worse it get, the more confident you get. Something got to come out of this thing. That's amen.
Amen.
I tell y'all things, I put everything on the line. I said, Lord, I cannot leave the little church, the little small congregation. I can't leave it if I don't have faith in you. The devil fight me, going down the 12th birthday, saying the bus wouldn't even start. I didn't tell y'all because I didn't want to hear your mouth. I didn't want to hear all kinds of things the people was going to say. I took it there running. I drove it in the yard and left it there running. It was running. I think I even walked off with it running. The man said, I've been moving it around. I don't know what's going on. I said, Lord have mercy. Saints, you got to have confidence in God. And the worse it got, the more I started believing. I said, we got to come out.
That's right.
And I couldn't tell everybody. I was just holding God. Lord, you got to. Yeah, I ain't want to. And then I thought about, Elder Thomas said he riding with us. Oh, Lord have mercy. Just can't cancel the thing. I'm going anyhow. You know God is good, son. That all things work together for good. Them that love the Lord. So the man reached that and he found the whole peace this morning. He said, this bus, I called him and I said, this bus runs with this peace. He said, man, no, it can't run with that one. Oh, who took it off? You know, the devil is a lying thing. So I'm thinking, and then I couldn't find other pieces to it. So I go running to International. I run to the place and the man told me, first he told me $100 and something. Then he said, it's a court charge. It's $273. So I said, well, I'm going to save the taxes. The Lord had me want to save taxes. I'm trying to find the tax ID number. You know God work everything in his will. Everything. God, you know sometimes God will move your back so he can do what he can do. Out of my phone always email. I'm going to send the thing to the man so he can get the tax ID so I can give him that $300. It wouldn't, my phone refused to cooperate. I said, you know what? That's all. I said, I'm going to run to Burger King. So I, and let me tell you, I went to Burger King, got me a bar. By the time I ate that waffle and them fries, that email was sent. I said, I got it now. I ran back up there. And when I got there, there was a short man named Chris standing around. He was at lunch when I was there the first time. So the man, I said, Chris, man. I said, I got it. He took me in the employee section, went to his toolbox, and got two little options. And said, look. He told, said, look. Put it on like this. He must know I am. The man gave me the little pieces. He had old pieces off somewhere. He gave them to me. And I went out of there saving $273. You know, God was detaining me, so I ran to his lunch and get back. Yeah. All things work together for good. Yeah. Don't you worry about it. Let God work it out. Yeah. You say, I should have been there then, but hold on. Give God the thanks. God might got a greater blessing for you than what you think. And I said, I was about to marry that and they slipped out of my head. God might got somebody better for you. Don't worry about it. I'm behind time. Everybody's ahead of me. Don't worry about it. Give God the glory.
Hallelujah.
God's got a better blessing for you.
You got a better one.
Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Amen. And there I was, believing God. I dreamed, my dreams was horrible. Woke up, forced something in the bathroom. I called the man wouldn't answer my phone call. Trying to get him to come early. And finally, his wife asked, I'm standing out in the road on King's Road with them two pieces. And the devil said, ain't no work. I said, devil, you're a liar. The devil said, you've got to have that peace you were going to buy. So, you know what? The devil will try to make it out. Says, I climbed in there like I was the best mechanic in Jacksonville. Got my little short self, and I climbed in that bus. I looked at that, I'm going to, and I let the Lord just die at that thing.
God did it. God did it.
You know God is good.
God did it.
Clint got the battery charger stuck in on there. I said, look at you. God saved my money, son. You know, somebody said, you need help, brother. I know I need help. But sometimes when God helps you, that's the best help ever. Isn't that the best thing? Y'all just didn't know what I was contending with. That's why it's not good to run your mouth about a person that's working for God. Yeah.
Oh, he always be king. You don't know the circumstance. It's good to hold your peace and pray sometimes. Pray through.
Yes.
First, amen. Cast not away therefore what you're confident.
For
what?
Which has greater.
And got great recompense of reward.
Mm-hmm. For ye have need of patience.
You have need of patience.
And after ye have done.
You don't throw your hands up and give up, say it didn't happen right then. You got to have patience with God.
Yes.
You got to have patience and let your faith work it out.
Yes.
Let patience have a perfect work. That you may be in trouble, wanting nothing.
God bless you.
But you got to have faith to God bring out.
Yes.
You got to have patience to let the thing work.
Yes.
Glory to God. Yes. Amen. Yeah, amen. Read it here.
Well, you have need of patience.
You have need of patience.
Then after ye have done.
After ye have done.
The will of God.
The will of God.
Ye might receive the promise.
You might receive the promise.
For yet a little while.
Yeah. A little while,
and he that shall come,
he
will
come. Shall come, will come,
and will not,
and tarry. Will not tarry.
For the judge shall live by faith.
Oh no, you playing with me? Is he playing with me? Did you find that in the New Testament?
Yeah.
The judge
shall live by faith.
You got to have faith. God bless you forever. Amen.